Hello, I am back. I'm going to be testing O2O makeup on camera with you guys. And they sent a bunch of things to me, but I also bought a few with my own coins. You can check out O2O Shopee page in the description down below. And you can also check out their social media. The shipping was extremely fast. It took like 5 days to arrive at my address. If you are interested to see what are the products, then please stay tuned. I have done my eyebrows off camera, but I haven't filled it in, so I'm gonna use the Shine Domineering Straight Eyebrow Dyeing Cream, and it's in code number 2. Essentially, this is eyebrow mascara. Tu nama fancy ja. The packaging is super aesthetic. Reminds me of I'm Mimi, a Korean brand. I don't know why, but it also reminds me a little bit of the Wardah Colorfit collection. What I'm gonna do is just carefully brush it on my eyebrow hair because I'm using brow soap. I'm going to focus this on the end of my eyebrow because that is where I need the most hairs. Gonna move on straight to the eyeshadow, and this is the Honeycomb Hexagonal Star Diamond Palette, and I think there are a few codes, and I chose this one, which is the most neutral tone one, if I'm not mistaken. And look at the packaging, just how gorgeous it is. It has interesting packaging and shape. It's not something we see in another brand, and it also has transparent packaging, so you can see what is inside. And the code I chose is 2, which is honey orange something. What is it? Honey orange yellow. Feels so soft. And then we also have like a matte here, and then I think this looks like a shimmery shade. It's not metallic, so all of them looks promising and pigmented. And I like that there's a complete mix of metallic and mattes inside because we can create like a complete look with one palette. I'm gonna use the Revolution eyeshadow base, and honestly, I have no idea of what look I wanna do, so I'm just gonna go with the flow. I'm gonna take this. This will be my first transition color. Ooh, it's actually pigmented. Shows up nicely on top of a dry base. I think I'm gonna do something simple like I always do. I hope you guys can see the color payoff through the camera or like your screen. But if you're interested to know what camera I'm using, I actually already link it down below. It's just that I haven't had any chance to talk about it yet. With a fluffy blending brush, I'm gonna take this right here, and I'll use this to further blend out the crease. This will be the color on my outer corner. It'll be the one that gives more depth to the eye look. Oh, it's not as dark as I want it to be, but I will try to build up the pigmentation. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's dark, but it's not as intense as it looks in the pan. I feel like doing a soft halo eyes today, so taking the same dark brown, I'll pack this in my inner corner. I'll try to apply this color using a brush first and see whether it shows up on the lid, and if it's not, okay, never mind, it shows up nicely. I was gonna use my finger. If it didn't show up on the lid, it's not as easy to spread them around. I'll switch to my finger. I applied primer off camera because I don't really have like any new primer from them to try, but I do have this pre-makeup powder, which supposedly you apply before applying foundation, and it has like a velvety, silky and transparent effect, which is suitable for any skin type or skin color, and it makes the skin looks matte. It's a frosted packaging, and I don't think it has any mirror in it, but it does look aesthetic. It doesn't have any colors, I believe, and It is... Hold on! It's a primer! Oh my god! It's actually like a balm primer. It's not powder. And it's transparent. Oh my god! I got it wrong! Because it says here, pre-makeup powder. Okay, I completely got it wrong. It's my bad because I didn't check it before opening. It's actually a balm type primer. Bukannya bedak. So, I don't know why they call it powder. And I already applied primer though. So, let me just like apply here on my smile area. Texture feels like a Vaseline but it's matte. It has a little smoothening effect. I actually have 3 foundation but I think I'm only gonna use one of them in this video. I have the foundation in a jar, the BB cushion and the liquid foundation. This one are both in the Shine collection but I'll use this one. This is in shade number 4 which is soft. I chose the darkest foundation is because I can always lighten it up with a concealer. Oh, the packaging is cute. I just saw it through my screen. It's so adorable. Oh my god. It's like chubby marshmallow like that. SPF 50+, PA++++. It has 30ml of product inside. By the way, the shimmers have some fallout. There's glitters under my eyes and I tried my best to remove it but I couldn't. So I redo, biarkan saja dia begitu dan hopefully dia tidak mengacau foundation kita. You know what? Even though this is like the darkest shade, it's not that dark, which is typical for Chinese brand because they tend to have lighter skin tone due to their demographic. So it's understandable. Slightly darker. It does have the signature foundation scent by O2O. It has low to medium coverage. Fun fact, I cannot stop buying foundation but I rarely use foundation these days. So I don't know what I'm thinking. Think in my mind, I'm gonna review it and I'm gonna use it daily. You can still see the redness peeking through my nose right here. Kalau zoom betul-betul, you can still see it. And then here also, the imperfection is still visible. So all in all, it's like a typical daily foundation where it's lightweight. It doesn't really have high coverage and it's suitable for people who doesn't really love wearing high coverage foundation because I know the trend these days is to use natural foundation and to use like a my skin but better type of formulation. I guess this is what O2O is trying to achieve with this collection. They want to cater to like young girls, the youth, the Gen Z. Before I apply concealer and set my face, I'm gonna use Glow Lift Light Shadow Contour Stick. This one is in code number 2. It's like the highlighter and contour duo. M Cosmetics was the first one to do this product and then the others copied them. That's like a fun fact I learned from Michelle Phan's video. This is the contour part. I'll swatch it on the back of my hand. It looks quite red. Oh no. The highlighter part looks like a concealer to be honest. Doesn't look like a highlighter at all. Yep. Looks like a concealer. So I'll apply this a little bit higher than usual. Like that. Nampak merah. Then blend it with a damp sponge. Why do I feel like it just disappeared? So let's try contouring the nose. Confident ah, contour hidung pakai cream product. I never do this before. This one seems to be blending out nicely. And untuk nose contour saya suka. Untuk di tulang pipi, enggak suka. Please be good. Please be good. Look at that. Cantik. And then for eyeliner, I'm gonna use the Cat Eye Stamp Eyeliner Pen. This is something that I'm not used to using because I don't typically draw cat liner. But this product is also dual-ended. This one is the stamp part. And then the other end is a thick eyeliner like that. This is felt tip liner. Please wish me luck. I don't want to ruin this look. That's not bad. Okay. Alamak, tidak rata. This one is a bit bawah sikit compared to that one. Ah, ni yang malas ni. And then using the felt liner tape, I'll fill in the gap. I finished the rest of my face off camera, and the last part is my lipstick, Soft Velvet First Love Lip Matte. It's in nombor 4 dan nombor 5. The packaging is similar with the eyebrow mascara. At the bottom here, you can see what are the shades. It reminds me of the Soft Warna lip product. This is shade number 4. Ooh, smells so nice. Macam bau gula-gula. Shade number 5. Color is a bit misleading from the photo, because in the photo it kind of look a little bit more brownish compared to the swatches in real life. So just keep that in mind. Apply number 5 all over my lips. And then taking number 4, I'll apply this at the center of my lips. It's not sticky and it feels comfortable. Sometimes there are lip mud like this that feels thick and it feels like it's sitting on top of the lips, but this one, it has like that velvety comfy finish. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching until the end, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.